This is a video guide on configuring a SilkTest Workbench database. From Start menu, Control Panel, Administrative Tools, on 64-bit operating systems. This is in fact the 64-bit version of the ODBC tool. SilkTest only supports the 32-bit version. Therefore, navigate to C Windows SysWow 64 ODBC Cat 32.exe for the 32-bit version. Once we launch the Data Source Administrator tool, go to the System tab and add a new data source using the SQL Server Native Client driver. We specify the data source name and also our database server name and any instance names that we may have created. If your database has been created with a SQL Server authentication, select the second option. Otherwise, if you're using Windows authentication, the first option will do. And choose the database. In this case, we're using this STWB recording. And click Next and click Finish. Now we'll test our data connection. And this completes our data source creation. Now we'll use the database maintenance tool to create our database tables. From File, New, SQL Server, click the Browse button to select the newly created data source. Specify the database owner, user ID, and password. If you don't have this information, your database administrator will be able to help. Click the Unlock Records to unlock the database tables. And close the maintenance tool. Now we're ready to use the database connection configuration tool to connect Workbench to our database. By default, the selected database is the Access database. Select the SQL Server option and select our newly created data source. And tick the checkbox, Use as a SilkTest Workbench database. Again, we'll provide the usual details of the database authentication. And click the Validate button. And apply. Now we're ready to launch SilkTest Workbench. Select your newly created data source. And on first installation, by default, the username and password for SilkTest Workbench is admin. And click OK. And this completes configuring a SilkTest Workbench database.